2020 election. The president touted his administration's record on job creation. He said the country had overcome the coronavirus pandemic and the assault on the US Capitol. He urged Republicans, who now hold a majority in the House of Representatives, to work with Democrats to help bring the USA together.
And to my Republican friends, if we could work together the last Congress, there's no reason we can't work together and find consensus on important things in this Congress as well. You all are as formed as I am, but I think the people sent us a clear message. Fighting for the sake of fighting, power for the sake of power, conflict for the sake of conflict gets us nowhere. That's always been my vision of our country, and I know it's many of yours. To restore the soul of this nation, to rebuild the backbone of America, America's middle class, and to unite the country.
But President Biden was booed and heckled as he criticized some Republicans for proposing cuts to Social Security and Medicare.
Instead of making the wealthy pay their fair share, some Republicans want Medicare and Social Security to sunset. I'm not saying it's a majority. Let me give you, anybody who doubts it, contact my office. I'll give you a copy of the proposal. That means Congress doesn't vote. Well, I'm glad to see you. No, I tell you, I enjoy conversion. You know, it means if Congress doesn't keep the programs the way they are, they'd go away. Other Republicans say, I'm not saying it's a majority of you. I don't even think it's even a significant, but it's being proposed by individuals.
Our North America correspondent Anthony Zerker told us more about this speech.
The point of Biden's speech is to make a case for his reelection. He hasn't announced that he's running for president yet, but any president who wants to win re-election needs to come up with some sort of a vision for the future, and finishing the job is his way of saying there's more to be done. He needs the Republicans in Congress to help him to enact his legislative agenda. And if they don't, then he can say, elect Democrats in 2024 and elect me in 2024, and what we've been promising we can deliver on. The biggest conflict in the coming Congress is going to be over raising the debt limit. The American Borrowing Authority, if they don't do that, then the nation will default on its national debt. That is something that's going to have to be done one way or the other. And that is a real source of conflict between Republicans and Democrats. Republicans want to condition raising the limit on cuts to the budget. Democrats want to just raise the limit, noting, as Joe Biden did in his speech, that the limit has been raised, was raised, three times under Donald Trump's presidency. So that is going to be something that will be very contentious. The abortion issue is one of the reasons why Democrats overperformed in last year's midterm congressional elections. It turned out Democrats to the polls, and Republican efforts to ban abortion have been fairly unpopular across the board. There have been some moves by Republicans to pass a federal abortion ban, nothing actually introduced as legislation yet in this Congress, but it is something that I think Democrats see as a way of rallying their base and also turning a popular issue.